Good evening, and welcome to Old St. Mary's Church as we gather to celebrate the Eucharist on this, the 20th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Please take a moment to silence all electronic devices, and let's stand and take a moment to greet one another. All of the readings for this Mass can be found on page 1251 in your hymnal, and the music and readings can be found in this week's worship aid. Feel free to follow along on your phone or device if you'd like, on the OSM Parish app, or click the Sunday Worship Aid link on the front page of our parish website, oldstmarys.com. Our gathering song is number 919, In Christ There Is No East or West, number 919. In Christ there is no east or west, in Him no south or north, but one great family bound by love throughout the whole wide earth. In Him shall true hearts everywhere their high communion find. His service is the golden cord, close binding humankind. Join hands, disciples, in the faith, whate'er your race may be, who serve each other in Christ's love are surely kin to me. In Christ now meet both east and west, in Him meet south and north. All Christly souls are one in Him throughout the whole wide earth.
Let us be gathered in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, we come together to give praise, worship, and honor to God, who is our protector and our strength.
Lord Jesus, you healed all who were called upon your grace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you sat at table with sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you call us to love each other as you love us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, one almighty Father, Lord
Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who have prepared for those who love you good things which no eye can see, fill our hearts with the warmth of your love, so that loving you in all things and above all things, we may come to your promises, which surpass every human desire. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just, for my salvation is about to come, my justice about to be revealed. The foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, ministering him, loving the name of the Lord, and becoming his servants, all who keep the Sabbath free from profanation and hold to my covenant, them I will bring to my holy mountain and make joyful in my house of prayer. Their burnt offerings and sacrifices will be acceptable on my altar, for my house shall be called a house of prayer for all peoples. The word of the Lord.
God, let all the nations praise you. O 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 God, be gracious and bless us, and let your face shed its light upon us. So will your ways be known upon earth, and all nations learn your salvation. O God, let all the nations praise you. O God, let all the nations praise you. Let the nations be glad and shout for joy. With uprightness you rule the peoples. You guide the nations on earth. You guide the nations on earth. Oh God, let all the nations praise you. Oh God, let all the nations praise you. Let the peoples praise you, oh God. Let all the peoples praise you. May God still give us his blessing, that all the ends of the earth may revere him. Oh God, let all the nations praise you. Oh God, let all the nations praise you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I am speaking to you Gentiles. Inasmuch as I am the apostle to the Gentiles, I glory in my ministry in order to make my race jealous and thus save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead? For the gifts and the call of God are irrevocable. Just as you once disobeyed God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience, so they have now disobeyed in order that, by virtue of the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God delivered all to disobedience, that he might have mercy upon all. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Lord, your servant is listening. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
At that time, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a Canaanite woman of that district came and called out, "Have pity on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But Jesus did not say a word in answer to her. His disciples came and asked him, "Send her away. She keeps calling out after us."
Jesus said in reply, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But the woman came and did Jesus homage, saying, "Lord, help me." But he said in reply, "It is not right to take the food of the children and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Please, Lord, even the dogs eat the scraps that fall from the table of their masters." Then Jesus said to her in reply, "O woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And the woman's daughter was healed from that hour. The Gospel of the Lord. Think about the Jesus we have enshrined in the stained glass memories of our minds. He's gentle, holding a wayward lamb across his shoulders, or he's kneeling, listening to a child, or stretching out a hand to heal the sick. This is a Jesus that we know from the Gospels and from the earliest stories we heard as children. He's gentle, compassionate, loving, and a friend of the outcast. He's the one who came to seek out and save every last, least, and lost one of us. His words were warm and wise and inviting and gracious, right? So what's going on in this gospel passage that was just proclaimed? Was Jesus just cranky that day? Tired from his exhausted schedule of travels and teaching? Was it that he only cared about his fellow Israelites and shared their low esteem for their Gentile neighbors? Or was it that Jesus' healing attention must be earned after a bit of witty repartee? The picture of a petty, insulting healer with a nationalistic bias just doesn't square with the rest of what the Gospels tell us about Jesus. After all, there are instances in the Gospels where Jesus didn't hesitate to grant the request of a foreigner, a non-believer, a sinner, a ritually unclean person. So there's something else going on in this story, but what? Perhaps it's that on the occasion recounted in today's gospel lesson, Jesus, with his disciples standing there listening in, recognized that he had at hand a genuine teaching opportunity, a teachable moment. The woman calls out to Jesus asking for healing for her daughter. But the disciples asked Jesus to send her away. She's proven to be a persistent bother. She's pestering us. So initially, Jesus appears to play the situation the way the disciples want him to. First, he ignores the woman's request. Then he tries to send her away with what seems to be an insult. It's not right to take the food from the children and throw it to the dogs. But she's had hurtful, disrespectful words hurled at her before. It's probably a daily experience. So this insult isn't anything new. She stands her ground. She won't be driven off. Even though Jesus tells her that his mission is only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, she senses that it's really a much more inclusive ministry. And though she's a Canaanite and not a Jew, she believes that she and her daughter are human beings created by God, and that they have worth, have value in the eyes of Jesus and in the heart of God. Hearing the woman's argument and sensing her deep faith, we can just imagine Jesus turning to his disciples to say, "Okay, well, I played it your way. You've heard this woman's argument. Now I'm going to teach you something about God's way of compassion and love for everyone." Then as we hear, Jesus says to the woman, "You have great faith. And yes, God does hear you and hear your need and that of your daughter, and he loves you both. Your daughter will be healed." He wanted the disciples, he wants us to model that love in our lives, in our ministry. Today's scripture text couldn't be more focused on what has become one of the most challenging social and political issues of our day. Call it immigration, refugee resettlement, sanctuary cities movement, undocumented labor, the Dreamers, or any other moniker, and we arrive at the same question. What does God say about people who are not exactly like us? The prophet Isaiah, living among the exiled Israelites in Babylon, tells the people that divine justice is about to be revealed. The prophet sees a day when God's justice and salvation will not only include the faithful whose ancestor is Abraham, but it will extend to all who love in the name of the Lord and who hold fast God's covenant. In the words of Isaiah, we hear one whose understanding of God's compassion and care is far more inclusive than the culture in which he lives. So profound was the prophet's message that at the time that Jesus cleansed the temple in Jerusalem, he is recorded as quoting Isaiah, declaring, "God's house is a house of prayer for all people." And today's scripture readings convey the truth of God's inclusive love and of the Father's invitation to be a loving, honest relationship with him. God loves us and wishes us to be whole, wishes us to be morally and spiritually healthy and strong. And through every aspect of our lives, our thoughts, our words, our actions, that's the message that Jesus wants us to bring to others. That's a wonderful and most acceptable gift, a most pleasing offering from us to God and to our neighbor. And it's a fulfillment of the desire of God expressed in those opening words of today's first reading from the prophet Isaiah. "Thus says the Lord, observe what is right, do what is just."
Let us stand now to renew our profession of faith, this evening using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us fill this house of prayer with our petitions.
That we, the Church, will welcome the stranger among us and that those who govern nations will be unafraid to break down barriers that divide and promote greater understanding and peace, we pray. For all administrators, teachers, and students as they begin a new school year, we pray. That parents and children will know strength through the prayers of this community, we pray. We continue to pray for those who have suffered the devastating fires on the Hawaiian island of Maui, and for all who are threatened by storm, flood, and fire. We pray. We pray that all who confess discipleship with Jesus will firmly reject all hatred, bigotry, and group supremacy. We pray. Help us to speak up for our sisters and brothers around the world who are the victims of human trafficking. We pray. That the sick, like the daughter of the Canaanite woman, will know the healing power of Christ. We pray. That those who have died, especially Raymond Kislevicus, will rest in eternal peace. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions that we hold in silence. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. O God of life, hear the prayers of your people voiced in the name of Jesus, your Son, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
As always, we thank you for your financial support of the ministries here at Old St. Mary's. Those who are joining us from a distance may mail your contributions to the parish office or set up an automatic giving account by going to the Give button on the Old St. Mary's website, oldstmarys.com. And as always, we thank you for your generosity.
Please join in singing number 755, There's a Wideness in God's Mercy, number 755. There's a wideness in God's mercy, like the wideness of the sea. There's a kindness in God's justice, which is more than liberty. There is plentiful redemption in the blood that has been shed. There is joy for all the members in the sorrows of the head. For the love of God is broader than the measures of the mind, and the heart of the eternal is most wonderfully kind. If our love were but more faithful, we should rest upon God's word, and our lives would be thanksgiving for the goodness of our Lord. Troubled souls, why will you scatter like a crowd of frightened sheep? Foolish hearts, why will you wander from a love so true and deep? There is welcome for the sinner, and more graces for the good. There is mercy with the Savior, there is healing
above the sea. There's a kindness in God's justice which is more than liberty. There is plenty for redemption in the blood that has been shed. There is joy for all the members in the sorrows of the head.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that our offering may be acceptable to God the Almighty. Receive our offering, O Lord, by which is brought about a glorious exchange, that by offering which you have first given, we may come to receive your very self, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For when your children were scattered afar by sin, through the blood of your Son and the power of the Holy Spirit, you gathered them again to yourself, that a people formed at one by the unity of the Trinity and made the body of Christ and the temple of the Holy Spirit might be the praise of your manifold wisdom, the Church. And so in the company of angels and saints we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure offering may be made to your name. And therefore, Lord, we implore you by that same Spirit to graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread and, giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when they had finished supper, Jesus took the cup. Once again, he gave you thanks, and giving it to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, and his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, And looking forward to his coming again, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with the Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Paul and all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Francis our Pope, and Blaise our Bishop, and the entire people that you have gained as your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this community that you have gathered here before you. In your compassion, O merciful God, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Join in our voices, we are bold to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we might be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look then not upon our sins, but upon the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Let us share with those around us some sign of the peace of Christ.
Behold,
The Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world, happy and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn will be number 1050, Broken for the Broken. It's number 1050. Broken for the broken, poured out for the poor. Blessed feast of God's creation, given for us all. Broken for the broken, shed for humankind. We proclaim your death, O Lord, God's sacrifice and sign. For the hungry ones, for the thirsty ones, for the lonely ones, you call us to serve, to be Christ for each other, broken for the world. Broken for the broken, poured out for the poor. Blessed feast of God's creation, given for us all. Broken for the broken, shed for humankind. We proclaim your death, O Lord, God's sacrifice and sign. For the ones abused, for the ones confused, for the ones refused, you call us to love, to be Christ for each other, broken for the world. Broken for the broken, poured out for the poor. Blessed feast of God's creation, given for us all. Broken for the broken, shed for humankind. We proclaim your death, O Lord, God's sacrifice and sign. For the voiceless ones, for the helpless ones, for the homeless ones, you call us to speak, to be Christ for each other, broken for the world. Broken for the broken, poured out for the poor. Blessed feast of God's creation, given for us all. Broken for the broken, shed for humankind. We proclaim your death, O Lord, God's sacrifice and sign. For the wounded ones, for the shattered ones, for the tired ones, you call us to help, to be Christ for each other, broken for the world. Broken for the broken, poured out for the poor. Blessed feast of God's creation given for us all, broken for the broken, shed for humankind, we proclaim your death, O Lord, God's sacrifice and sign.
Let us pray. Made partakers of Christ through these sacraments, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that conformed to his image on earth, we may be co-heirs with him in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for just a moment. As always, thank you for joining us for worship here this evening, both in person and those who are joining us from a distance. As always, please be sure to take a copy of today's bulletin. The information in the bulletin is also published on the parish website and the OSM parish app. Among the items in today's bulletin is a list of agencies that are seeking and accepting donations to assist those affected by the fires in Maui, so please see that. Chicago Share vouchers are on sale after Mass today. These vouchers can be given to people that approach you asking for assistance, and they can be used at local grocery stores and restaurants. And they're for sale on the third weekend of the month each month. So stop by the table in the Commons. Any visitors or newcomers with us today, would you please stand so we could recognize you? Any visitors or newcomers to Old St. Mary's? Okay. All right, well, welcome. Now, here's another question. Who's ready to start school tomorrow? I think the parents are more excited about that, so that's good. Well, good luck tomorrow. You are starting tomorrow, too?
No.
Oh, okay. Sunday. Oh, that's right. Thank you, Matthew, for correcting me. All right. Monday. You're going to start Monday. Okay. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the blessing of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go forth in the peace of God.
Our closing hymn is number 904, If You Believe and I Believe, number 904. If you believe and I believe and we together pray, the Holy Spirit must come down and set God's people free, and set God's people free, and set God's people free. The Holy Spirit must come down and set God's people free. If you believe and I believe and we together pray, the Holy Spirit must come down and set God's people free. And set God's people free. And set God's people free. The Holy Spirit must come down and set God's people free.
This always goes back because they changed the name. This is just 5 o'clock on here. They do another one for 8. Oh, okay.